हेलो। वैभव, आई हैव गॉट दिस विंडो दैट दिस मीटिंग इज बीइंग रिकॉर्डेड
यस यस सर, यस सर,
बाय कंटिन्यूइंग
या या
दिस
या
योर।
कंटिन्यू इट।
सो आई वॉट आई ओके कंटिन्यू राइट बिकॉज आई एम डूइंग इट फर्स्ट टाइम नो सो आई डोंट नो वट इज दिस। ओके फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर मनोज, आई विल बी टीचिंग यू सब्जेक्ट कॉल्ड स्ट्रैटेजिक कॉस्ट मैनेजमेंट। ओके, टॉकिंग अबाउट माई एजुकेशनल बैकग्राउंड, बेसिकली आई हैव डन माई बी कॉम ऑनर्स एंड देन आई हैव डन माई एम बी ए फाइनेंस फ्रॉम सिम्बायोसिस इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ बिजनेस मैनेजमेंट, passed out in 89, and then I've done few other things also. Presently I'm running my own consultancy and going as a visiting faculty to institutes like Symbiosis, Pumba, MIT and others. I've taught almost more than 40 institutes in India. So in all I have professional and industry or teaching experience of almost 32 years. Okay, I'll be teaching you a subject called strategic cost management. Now, whenever we are talking about strategic cost management, the three percent is strategic, second one is cost, and third one is management. Okay. So, what do you understand by strategic or a strategy? Hello? Yes? By strategy, hello, what do you mean by strategy? No one is there. Hello. Hello. Is anyone there?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
No, no, I am audible, but who is there? I am audible, but I just asked, what do you mean by strategy? Yes, Rajesh.
Hello, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Strategy
yes,
is
Rajesh.
a general plan. It means a
okay.
planning for the company.
Okay.
How it's moving forward.
Okay, right. Okay. Now, we are not going into definitions and all, right?
Okay.
Yeah, but we are just thinking. You must have studied this strategy, strategies and all that is under, say, PPM subject or something, management subject. Am I correct?
Correct, sir.
So generally what you're saying is strategy means basically like a plan, right? Right, a plan, policy or something like that, correct Rajesh?
Correct, correct sir.
Right, and then what do you understand by cost?
Sir, in general term, cost means the price of any commodity on which at which the company is going to sell the product in the market.
Going to sell the product in the market, that is it cost?
Sorry sir, the production cost, the cost at which the company is produce the goods.
Okay. So basically, when we talk about cost, cost means related with expenses. Am I
Expensive.
correct, Rajesh?
Yes, sir.
Right.
All expensive. Yes.
Ha, correct, correct. So you will say whatever expenses we incur, right, in a company, we will term them as a cost, right? And then what do you understand by management? Or anyone else? Steps of management. What do you understand by management? Yes, Rajesh. Sorry, my internet connection is unstable, right? It's... Yes, Rajesh.
Management means, sir, controlling the things.
Controlling the case.
Controlling the things, yeah.
Okay, so basically, when you say management, basically you talk about management of planning, control,
Yeah, in that term, yes, sir.
correct?
How
In
to manage
that,
the things, yeah.
yes, Rajesh, continue, complete.
Yes, how to manage the things means
How to?
how you are going to how you are going to control the particular. Say in cost, we are now right now we are discussing the cost. So how you are going to manage the cost? How you are controlling these unnecessary things in the production or while managing the manufacturing process? So am I on the correct track, sir?
Right. So basically, when. Yes. I'm just asking, what do you mean by management?
Yes,
Correct?
sir. Okay.
Right. Basically, you must have studied management, PPM subject in this. So basically, what we're talking about is planning, control, analysis, and so many other things. Correct? Which comes under management.
Correct, sir.
Correct. And what you said rightly as one of the things is about cost control and all, right? It will come under cost management, right?
Yes,
So now when we combine these three words, strategic cost management, what is will be the strategies, which is Rajesh,
Yes, sir.
right?
Sorry.
Huh, the meaning of strategic cost management in simple terms in that case will be what will be the strategies company will be following for cost management. Am I
Cost.
right?
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. You see, whenever you read books or something like that, we will get definitions, but we should understand in a simple terms. Correct?
Correct.
Correct. So strategies basically, like you said, it will be some kind of plan, right? Some kind of policies which will implement in cost management. Correct?
Good.
Right. Now, yeah. So whenever we are going to study this subject, right, strategic cost management, it is basically related with cost management. So if you understand cost management, if you understand the cost as a concept we be able to understand what strategies we can implement for strategic management. And you must have studied as a subject also, strategic management. Have you studied this subject, strategic management? So you have studied this, huh? Correct. You have studied this strategic management as a subject also. So all those kinds of policies, strategies, and all, right? How we can implement them under cost management. So that will become then our strategic cost management. And whenever we are talking about then cost management, so we are thinking about different types of cost and then how we can implement, develop some strategies related to that cost. Correct. So we must understand the basic concept under cost management. Right now, what types of cost generally we are, why is it important to study cost now? Cost management? Is it important?
Yes, for any company, cost is very important.
Right. Why?
Because the lower the cost of a particular product, you will be more competitive in the market.
Very correct. Very correct. Right? See, basically, what has happened, see, in a very olden days, like when you businessmen started business, how they started calculating, basically, whenever you are running a business, for what reason you are running it?
For making profit or earn.
Very correct. Very correct. Yes.
Yes, sir. For return on, it means how will you interpret this, sir? To generate more profit. Or
correct.
To generate money, yes, sir.
Very correct, very correct, very correct. Everyone, whoever is an entrepreneur, investor, right? They are interested in earning return on their investment, correct? Because they are taking risk. So they are looking for the profit, correct? So why we are interested in studying the cost? Because we have to calculate profit in business, correct? And when we calculate profit in business, right? Generally, how do you calculate profit as a simple businessman? How you'll calculate profit?
It's in general terms, say manufacturing cost plus your admin cost, selling and distribution plus your profit margin is equal to your selling this one.
No, I'm asking you, how will you calculate profit?
COGS minus your price.
Is it price minus COGS or COGS minus price?
Price minus COGS.
Okay, price minus COGS. Okay, so in other terms, what we can say is COGS means you are saying is cost of goods sold.
Yeah.
Correct? Cost of goods sold. In other terms, generally people use terminology called sales. Am I correct?
Yes, sir. Perfectly.
Right. So, as we are studying MBA and we are studying cost and all, you must have done this cost accounting in the first semester, correct? Under management accounting.
Yes, sir.
Right. So, under that we have studied basically sales minus cost is equal to profit. That is your revenue minus total cost, and then you say that is my profit. In simple terms, correct? So when businessmen started doing business, see, take example like 200 years, 300 years, do you think they must have had this kind of subject, strategic cost management? No, they never studied such type of subject. Even take example, when I did my MBA, 87-89 from Symbiosis, right? We didn't have this subject, strategic cost management. We have just studied this as a chapter or such, as a concept, okay? But so even in olden days, these people must be using this concept, strategic cost management, but they have never studied as a special subject. What is being important? Businessman means to calculate simple thing, like we said, sales minus cost is equal to profit, right? So in those days, sales were independent factor, okay, right? So sales, whatever is the revenue of that business, they used to calculate, okay, this is my revenue, what is this is my income from the business. From that, they used to deduct whatever expenses they have incurred as cost. Right, so revenue, sales minus cost, right? So cost was again a independent factor. Whatever you are incurring expenses, they used to term them as a cost, and then they used to calculate profit. So profit was a depending factor, right? So profit is the difference between sales minus cost, correct? Okay, but then slowly in the next stage, the businessmen started becoming little. They said that whenever I'm going to do business, right, I must earn some level of profit, right? So to earn some level of profit, then I have to decide what should be my selling price. Correct. So what these businessmen started doing? They started calculating cost. Right. So cost has become as an independent factor. Right. Okay. This is my cost. Say X amount is my cost. Then when they used to say that when I want to run this type of business, I want certain rate of return. So they used to add profit to it. Right. So profit had become independent factor. Okay. Because it is an expected return by the investor, entrepreneur, businessman. Right. So then they used to calculate what should be my cost. Correct. So, what should be my selling price? So cost is an independent factor. Then profit is an independent factor. So cost plus profit is equal to sales, right? And that sales which they should achieve to earn that level of profit. So whatever sales they have used to calculate, that they used to divide by the number of units, and then they used to say this should be my selling price of the product. Okay, so the first equation was sales minus cost is equal to profit. Okay, then second equation it became, that is cost plus profit. But now businesses become very competitive nowadays, right? 300 years back, 500 years back, there was no concept called company, right? But in last 100 year, 200 years, right? This type of business, company form of business, is becoming flourishing all over the world, right? So whenever companies are running businesses, right? Now what they have started doing is, they started now moving to the third equation. What is that third equation? They say now is, sales is my independent factor, because sales is determined by the market, right? It is not in my hands. Like take example, recently whatever is this pandemic is happening, most of the companies lose sales. If you just take example, like automobile sector of sales, because the retailers are closed, the showrooms are closed, stockists are closed, right? Because they cannot move their goods. Customers cannot come to the showrooms and buy two-wheelers or four-wheelers and so on. So their sales have gone down, right? So now sales is becoming independent factor, because now it has become a competitive world. Correct? So sales is become independent factor. Then in a company form of business, you must have studied, we manage business as the like a professional people, right? Business is a separate entity for us. And in that case, then what we say is, whatever assets I require to run a business, I have to acquire finances. Just we say, balance sheet, right hand side is assets, left hand side is liabilities. But we say like that, right hand side is my application of funds and left hand side is my sources of funds. Correct, Rajesh?
Yes, sir, correct.
Right. So whenever we are talking about, and that is basically the financial management. Correct. Whenever we are talking businessmen nowadays, businessmen or managers who are handling this company form of business, they are thinking that whatever finances I am raising, I am incurring some cost to that. Okay, cost of capital, what we call them as cost of capital. Or in other words, we can say that, whatever investment I am getting from my investors in my company, they are expecting certain level of profit. Correct. So the nowadays what is happening, companies are having desired level of profit. Like take example, whenever you will be working as managers in company, the company will ask you, top people will ask you to give presentations, and then they will ask you what in the coming year, right? And then you will be giving presentations that next year we are planning of producing so much things, so much types of goods, number of goods, and what we are thinking of, the price will be so much, and then this will be our revenue in the near future, that is in the next year, or you can say on the quarterly basis or half yearly basis. And then you will give presentation to the management, that is this much will be our profit in the next coming year. Correct. So what is happening here nowadays is sales is becoming independent factor, then profit is also becoming now independent factor. Correct. Now take example, Rajesh, now you have money with you. Okay. You decide to invest in a company, Gauri, Karan. There are so many, Suraj, Nishant, Priyanka, Anaga, Neelam, Akshada, Ankita, Kedar. Yes. Whenever you are going to put your money into any company or business, right, on what basis you will decide to invest? Okay, right. You will decide or seeing your risk in that particular business and whether that company will be going to give you certain level of profit or not. Am I right? Okay, like suppose take example, you want to have a return on your investment of say 15%. Okay, and if a particular company is there which is going to give you 12% rate of interest or say 12% rate of return, then in that case you will say, no, I'm not interested in this company to invest because this is not going to give me the expected profit or return. Okay, you will look for a company which is going to give you 15% or more than that. Okay, so nowadays what is happening is there is a certain level of expected profit which we have to run the business. What is left over is now cost. So now the equation is sales minus profit is equal to cost, right? So like taking suppose example, if I am selling a X product, then the selling price in the market, in the competitive market of that particular product of that particular quality is say of 100 rupees. Okay, now when I am selling that product for 100 rupees, my investors are expecting to earn profit of 10 rupees per product. Correct. So that means to earn 10 rupees per product, I have to produce that product and sell, okay, at 90 rupees, because sales is 100, my cost is 90. Sorry, cost is, sorry, my profit is 10, so my cost should be 90 equal to cost, that is 90. Correct. So whenever we are looking for this, now the strategic cost management, so I have to manage my cost in 90 rupees. Okay, so when while managing that cost in 90 rupees, so I need to implement some planning or strategies and so on. So that's why this subject is becoming more and more important. Correct. Now, so when we'll be studying this subject, strategic cost management, I'll be using various terminologies, right, related with cost and so on. So let's just understand what kind of concepts which we'll be using here, right? You know all these concepts, okay? You must have studied this under your management accounting, right? A cost, right? Now, what do you mean by cost? Cost means, in other terms, what we'll say is whatever expenditure I have incurred, actual as well as notional, okay, or attributable to a specific product, service, or an activity. So that is basically which we use term as a costnal. Yes. What do you mean by notional? Okay. So whatever the cost which we are incurring in the company, we will consider it, right? Whether it is actually incurred, whether it is not actually paid or something like that, but I will consider that as a my cost incurred, okay? So notional, attributable, okay? And then I will try to find out how much is my total cost, right? So the expenditure incurred, right, on a specific product, correct? Now, why we are looking for an activity here is basically because nowadays, why we are interested in calculating the cost of cost of an activity? Or a service? Okay, because nowadays what we can do is, instead of having that our in-house service or an activity, we can outsource it. If some other party is there who can give me the service at a lesser price, right, at a lesser, so in other words, at lesser cost, okay, we will outsource it, correct? So that's why we need to understand the cost of service or an activity, right? So in simple terms, cost will be expenditure incurred, correct? Then we use term like costing, okay? So costing is defined as the technique and process of ascertaining cost of products, activities, or services, right? So when we use this terminology called costing, right, so what we'll talking about is, it's basically the technique and process of ascertaining cost, how to calculate cost, how we'll use the various types of cost also, correct? Then costing system. Okay, so what is a costing system? So costing system is basically, it's very important for the business, right? Because it is basically the foundation of the internal financial information system for managers, because managers will be taking various types of decisions, and whenever they are going to take various types of decisions, they need financial information, right? So whether we are talking about internal financial information, managerial information, or the data related, how much cost we are incurring, right? So the organization has to develop some costing system, correct? So it provides the information that managers needs to plan and control the organization's activities and to make decisions about the future, correct? So that we call as costing system, right? Then you must have studied about this strategy, cost accounting, right? So whenever we're talking about cost accounting, right, what we have studied under management accounting in the first, that is, it is the process of accounting of cost, which begins with the recording of income and expenditure, or the basis on which they are calculated, and ends with the preparation of periodical statements report for ascertaining and controlling cost. Right. What is the other type of accounting you have studied? Yes. What are the types of accounting which you have studied under management accounting basically? All of you have studied this subject, management accounting, in the first sem? Hello? What is another set of accounting other than cost accounting which you have studied? Hello? Yes? Anyone? Hello? Anyone? What is another set of accounting you have studied?
Yes, sir. Is it financial accounting,
Very correct.
management, and
Very correct. Very correct,
corporate?
Rajesh. Very correct. I think, Rajesh, you are the only, I think, attending the lecture, right? I think others have just joined the lecture. Am I right? Yes, Rajesh.
Yes, sir.
I think you are the only person who is attending the lecture, right? Others have just joined.
No, sir, my other colleagues are also there, sir.
But then nobody is talking here. There is no reply from anyone. Karan, Gauri, Suraj, Nishant, Anaga, Neelam, Akshada, Mehel, Ankita, Kedar. There is no response from them. You are the only responding. So I think others have just joined. Right, and not attending. There is a difference between attending and just joining. Okay, right. So correct, very correct. Like you said, Rajesh, it's financial account. So what is the purpose of basically the financial accounting, Rajesh?
Sir, in financial accounting, we are means plotting the what is the income expenses. Means just simply doing accounting in financial
Correct.
perspectives.
Okay, right. So what do you do under financial accounting? How do you calculate profit? And what statements you prepare?
Is P&L account, profit and loss account,
Correct. Correct. And
balance sheet.
correct. Very correct. Right. So we prepare profit and loss account and balance sheet under financial accounting to understand what is the profitability and profits of the organization. We prepare P&L account, right? And to understand the financial position of the company, we prepare balance sheet. Correct, Rajesh? Okay,
Correct, sir.
right. So that is a one type of accounting. Then there is another type of accounting which is called as cost accounting. And why we are studying this cost accounting? Because in a business, we have to understand what will be the cost of my the product. Correct? So if I calculate the cost of a product or a service, I can price it, right? So financial accounting doesn't help us here, right? And financial accounting, what we do is we calculate our income revenue that we show on profit and loss account credit side. On the debit side of P&L account, we show all our expenses incurred, right? Actual or as well as notional and all, right? So we show everything there, and then we calculate profit or loss, correct, in P&L account. But so P&L account doesn't help us in deciding the selling price of the product, the cost of the product, right? So there is another accounting methodology which is called as cost accounting, right? So cost accounting helps us in ascertaining the what is my cost, right? And this also helps us in controlling the cost, because as I am having data of cost account cost with me, right, then it will also help me in controlling it, so I can get the desired level of profit. So cost accounting is a type of accounting process that aims to capture company's cost of production by assessing the input cost at each step of production, as well as fixed cost such as depreciation of capital equipment, that is say assets. Cost accounting will first measure and record these costs individually and then compare the input cost or input results to output or actual results to aid the company's management in measuring performance, right? So cost accounting is basically the accounting process, right, that will help me in calculating various types of input cost. Now what types of cost we incur in business? Yes, Rajesh.
Sir, it's material cost, labor cost, transportation, admin expenses.
Salary. Very correct. Material cost, labor cost. Correct, correct. Manufacturing cost. Correct. Then we say factory cost. Right. Administration cost, as you rightly said, sales and distribution cost. Right. So we need to calculate these types of various types of cost. Correct. Okay. So we can measure the performance of the company, right? And nowadays we are not looking at the overall profit. Like take example, whenever a company is calculating profit by using financial accounting, right, it will give you overall profit figure in a P&L account, right? But nowadays when we are selling, take example, like if you are selling four types of products, okay, now in that case you are interested in knowing that whether I am earning profit from each product or not, correct? P&L account does not help you in finding out that, okay, but cost accounting will help you in finding out what profit you are earning from different say your products which you are, or services which you are selling and earning the revenue, correct? So that becomes very important. So what we do in the management nowadays, like we will try to calculate what product is giving me profit. If a particular product is not giving me profit, I will try to improve upon my strategies about or say whatever the cost which I am incurring on that particular product, right? I will try to reduce it, okay, and so many other things, and I will try to get profit from that particular product. Even after taking some effective measures, right, I am not getting profit from that particular product, then in that case you will, right? So we need to understand this type of decision making, correct? So cost accounting helps us, financial accounting doesn't help us much there, so we go for cost accounting. So it helps us in measuring performance of each product, right, of each services also, and so on, correct? Now cost accountancy can be defined as the application of costing, right, and cost accounting principles, methods and techniques to the science, art and practice of cost control and ascertainment of profitability, right? So cost accountancy will be is basically as a overall costing, okay, application of cost accounting principles, methods, techniques. And why I'm going to use this, okay, it's basically I want to control my cost, I want to control my expenses, right? So my profits will not go down. So ascertainment of profitability is becomes one of the key things. So it includes presentation of information derived from for the purpose of managerial decision making, right? So that's why this subject is becoming very important, right? Strategic cost management. Now it is taught to you as a specialized subject, right? Even there is a one more subject called strategic financial management, right? So these two subjects are becoming now very important subjects. Because this cost, right, strategic cost, strategic financial management is becoming now very important to be a very competitive in the world. Okay, now and nowadays, you know why I'm using the word as world, because you know nowadays businesses are globalized, economies are opened up, right? What for 40 years back India was. Right, how India was running the internal businesses, right? They are not the same today because of the globalization, right? Because India is opened up now to FDI, right? Free imports, exports, and so many other things, right? 40 years back, it was a controlled economy, right? So things are changing. Now this is a globalized world. So world is a market, right? So we need to understand all these costing, cost accounting principles and so on, right, for making various managerial decisions, right? So that's why the strategic cost management is becoming very important subject, right? And then what we should try to understand here is basically these four concepts: cost center, cost unit, cost object, and profit center. Because whenever I'll be discussing strategic cost management in detail, right, I'll be using these terminologies: cost center, cost unit, cost object, profit center, and so on. So you should just understand this. What do you mean by that? Okay, so I'm just revising these. All these things you have studied in the first semester under management accounting. Okay. Some of you are not giving me answers and all. I'm not asking you who taught you management accounting, okay? But he must have covered all these things, okay? So what do you mean by cost center? Now, cost center means, yes, someone was saying something. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Mehel.
No, sir, we all there, sir.
No, I know you are there. But only thing is, you are not participating. See, I am not asking you like what do you, my definitions and all. I am just asking you what you understand by this terminologies, because when I'll be teaching you this subject in detail, right, I'll be using this terminology. If you don't understand the terminologies and basic things, then it will be very difficult to understand advanced level, right? Because strategic cost management is a advanced level subject. Am I right, Karan? Mel?
Yes, sir, you're right.
Because this is a fourth semester subject, right? So the assumption is you know all these terminologies. Correct. So I'm just revising this. What do you understand by cost center? Okay. Cost center is basically a location, person, or item of equipment, right? Or a combination of this. That means location as well as person or item, in the respect of which cost is ascertained for the purpose of cost control, right? So whenever I want to calculate the cost of a particular thing, okay, right, so that will become a cost center to me. Like, take a simple example. Suppose I am having a welding shop, okay, where the welding is going on, right? So that will become a cost center to me. Take another example, like suppose I am having an assembly line, you know, in automobile sector, vehicles are produced on assembly, right? That is a production method which they use. So assembly line will become a cost center for me. So I will try to find out how much cost I incur to assemble a car or to assemble a two-wheeler, say motorcycle or a scooter or something like that. Okay, so that becomes a cost center for us. Then take example, suppose I have a accountancy department, right? So I will try to find out how much cost I incur on accountancy department. So accountancy department becomes my cost center. Okay, so cost center is basically like a location, person, or item of equipment, or a combination of this. Example, like we are just talking about assembly line where the machines are there, correct? So I'll be using this terminology, cost center, right? So cost center means you just understand whatever is a place or something like that of which I want to calculate cost for the purpose, then of obviously is for the cost control, correct? Then second concept which we'll be generally using under this subject is cost unit, right? So cost unit means it's a basically unit of product, service, or time in relation to which the cost is ascertained, correct? So take example like a unit. So when you say like I am producing say two wheelers, okay, you will say what is the number of wheelers you produce? So number is become a cost unit in this particular thing, right? Then suppose you take example, you are producing oil, correct? Then in case of oil, you will say not a number, you will say liters of oil, correct? Or in some heavy industry, you may use terminology called as ton. So you will try to find out a cost per unit. You will try to find out cost of per, say, liter, or you will try to find out cost per ton. Whatever it is related to your industry, so that becomes a cost unit. Then take example, like suppose it is in a transport business. So in a transport business, you will try to find out how much is the cost which you incur per kilometer. Correct? So that becomes a cost unit, right? So we'll be using this terminology. Cost unit under strategic cost management, right? Then next thing is a cost object, right? So what is a cost object? Anything for which a separate measurement of cost is considered necessary or desirable, right? So whenever you feel that I need to calculate a cost of a particular whatever an activity or whatever is there, right, you will term them as your cost object. Okay, so cost object is where there is a separate measurement of cost. Okay, so there is a separate measurement of cost. It's considered necessary or desirable. Then you will say that is my cost object. Okay, so we'll be using this terminology, cost object. And the last one is profit center. So it is something like a cost center. Under cost center, we are talking about location, person, or item of equipment to ascertaining cost, right? So under profit, we will try to understand these are various types of centers for me, which will be giving me profits. Okay, so whenever we are talking about profit, obviously it has to be related with some income also. So if a particular unit, if there is no income, okay, we cannot calculate profit there, right? So always remember that all profit centers, right, will be cost centers, okay? But all cost centers will not be profit centers, okay? Because some cost centers do not earn profit. Like take example, accountancy department. Accountancy department doesn't earn any profit as such because they are not generating any revenue, okay? But sales department, right, or say I'm having the product, or a service, right, or a systems, right? So they can, wherever they can earn some revenue, I will consider them as profit center, right? So profit center is a segment of business which is responsible for all activities, right, involved in services. Correct? All of you are clear with this?
Yes, sir.
Right. So we'll be using these terminologies. Okay. Cost center, cost unit, cost object, and profit center. Okay. Now, please remember one thing is, whenever now I'll be using these terminologies in the future, I will not explain them to you again. Okay. Because I have already discussed this, because we have very short time. Okay. When is your exam? Well,
so the date is not given yet.
But
tentatively, it will be the next month.
Acha, next month. Oh.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Our syllabus is of 30 hours. Okay. So let us try to take classes.
Right.
Okay, syllabus is of 30 hours, right? So I will try my best. Okay. Any other doubt here? Right. So for this strategic cost management, so what we should understand basically is, what is the cost, what is the costing system, is cost accounting, right, and plus returned profit center, then only we can formulate various strategies, correct? So our basics has to be very strong. That's why this subject is taught to you in the first semester, okay, under management accounting. It is very important for us, and then especially for the finance people. I think all of you are finance students.
Yes, sir.
Right. And how many students are there, Rajesh? Finance. How many specialization students are there? Yes, Mehul.
Sir, I don't know about finance, sir.
You don't know about how many students are there in specialization?
Sir, I'm marketing specialization, sir.
Then how come you are attending this lecture?
Sir, I thought, sir, it's a general subject. That's the reason.
Achha, okay. Is it allowed like that?
Sir, because I did not know, sir, this is an finance subject.
So your specialization is marketing, well,
right?
Okay. This subject is basically for finance people. This is finance specialization, sir.
Okay.
Right. So that's why this is very important. Okay, and that's why I think, Mahal, you were not participating much, because I was asking from the finance point of
understanding much of the things, sir.
Yes. Okay. Shall we stop here?
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. Are you clear about this?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes, Mahal, you are saying something?
Sir, I was saying that that's the reason I was not understanding anything.
Yes, it happens, because you are studying, so you lose the touch, correct? As
right.
You have taken market finance related subjects in the third semester, correct? But in the first semester, you have studied management accounting. Second semester, you must have studied financial management.
Yes. So there is a little bit of connection.
Correct. Okay. What's about you, Mel? Are you placed?
Yes, sir.
Very nice. Very good. Which company?
Sir, I'm working in Curious Design, sir.
Sorry, there was some noise, vehicle noise. Can you
report? What, sir?
Which company you said?
Curious Design.
Curious design. Okay. And where you are based?
Sir, it's at Shivaji Nagar, sir. Like University Road.
Okay, okay. So you are in Pune only?
Yes, sir, Pune.
And you are from which place, Mel?
Sir, I'm from Pune itself, sir. Oh, born and brought up here only.
Okay. Same thing here, okay? I'm also born and brought up in Pune only.
How are you keeping now, sir?
Huh?
How are you keeping now?
How are you?
How are you keeping now, sir? How are you feeling now?
It is so nice. Online lectures are going on, no?
Okay.
I basically teach to institutes like Symbiosis and others like Pumba, Pune University Management Department.
Oh, that's great, sir.
And I myself have done MBA from passed out in 89.
Oh.
Okay. It would have been great to have a classroom sessions, you know, so we can interact more and all. Okay.
Right, sir.
Right. But unfortunately, because of this pandemic, we cannot see, right? In last full year, almost like online lectures are only going on.
Right, sir.
Right. So my lecture is generally from 7 to 8.
Okay. So because we even have a common lecture also at 7 to 8. Yes.
Okay. So if you want to attend my lecture, Mel, it's okay, right?
Right, sir. I'll do that, sir. Definitely.
Okay. Basically, in a marketing and all, you use this, you need this information. Okay, it's a very important subject.
Right, sir.
Okay, because whenever we'll be studying and say the advanced costing techniques, like, you know, so target costing, then activity-based costing, then let's say life cycle costing and so on. Okay, so even these related with some like marketing and all. Okay, so if you want, you can attend this lecture, no issue. Right?
Sure, sir.
But only one thing, one request is don't ask me difficult questions, okay?
No, sir.
Otherwise, you are a marketing expert. Okay? even my market, my time, we used to have only one. Do you have a dual specialization or one specialization?
No, sir. We have a single specialization, sir.
Under Pune University, right?
Right, sir.
Same, but only thing what we were allowed, you know, my time 87, 89, that we were allowed to sit even in this other specialization classes also, like, okay, it is to be, they used to take just internal examinations for that.
Okay.
Right. Okay. So shall we stop here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you must be having another lecture now from 8 to 9, correct?
Right, sir.
Right. So, thank you, all of you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mel, Rajesh, and all others. Okay, next time, start participating it, right? Because this online, if it becomes one way, you know, it becomes very boring. I cannot teach that effectively if there is no response, like from Rajesh or Mehal. Okay, so for the students, I'm just requesting you, please participate. Okay, so we will share our knowledge, right? So it is a give and take. Even I will learn many things from you people. Okay, right. So thank you very much. Good day.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.